staggering. 90% unemployment, just as many families living below the poverty line.
That's what life on the reservation often means, but not always. About an hour and a half north of Omaha, the Winnebago in Thurston County are trying to shed one of the highest unemployment rates in the state and low education. So we went there to see how they're reinventing the reservation.
Throw out the stereotype of life on the reservation.
Dribble, dribble. Oh, just about.
The Winnebago tribe is bouncing back. Ask anyone.
The undersea mutant follows the call to adventure.
Like Don Blackburn.
Wherever danger goes, the mutant follows.
He went to Winnebago's St. Augustine Mission School. Now he's the principal, its first Native American principal. Times have changed.
I used to sit on this hill top out here, and there was nothing out here. And now there's this bustling little redeveloped community across the street.
And just up the street, this will soon be an EduCare facility, the first to be built on a reservation. A $10 million preschool and daycare backed by Susie Buffett's Early Childhood Fund.
They can close the gap between the haves and the have-nots in regards to their early childhood development.
Father Dave Korth, director of St. Augustine's and priest to several reservation communities, calls it a game changer, not only for the kids, but for the families. Families used to struggling, who now see the investment giving their future a shot.
It's amazing what employment does for a person in terms of seeing hope.
Education is only one reason hope is back. Back in 92, the Winnebago opened Winnevegas Casino. It's been so successful, the casino's now expanded into a resort. But the tribe's not only resorting on this money, they're covering their economic bets.
Welcome to Ho-Chunk Village.
Enter Ho-Chunk Incorporated. Ho-Chunk is the original name of the Winnebago, translated roughly as people of the big voice. And with 34 subsidiaries, Ho-Chunk Inc. is making a statement. Founded by Native son Lance Morgan, it provides jobs in production, distribution, sales, and even just opened this building off the reservation in Bellevue. They do a lot of contract work on nearby Offutt Air Force Base. Yet another win for the Winnebago. You see, they're trying to buck the trend. 26% of Native Americans live below the poverty line, more than any other group, double the national average. In 2003, the Bureau of Indian Affairs put unemployment on the Winnebago Reservation at 53%. Just 2 years later, it dropped to 39%, and some now estimate it to be half that.
My grandfather was a hereditary chief for the tribe.
John Blackhawk, Winnebago tribal chairman, credits the tribe's success to long-term and consistent planning.
Unless you do some serious planning, things don't really happen to change a lot.
And while change is good, everyone we talked with wants to make sure it doesn't crowd out their heritage. This park is located in Winnebago's growing Ho-Chunk Village. It's a mix of businesses and homes where people can live, work, and shop. It's in demand, and by many natives who've left.
We have more people that are coming back or wanting to come back. We have a kind of a critical housing shortage. We need about 200 homes to even come close to catching up.
I'm selling homes, I'm buying homes.
Sarah Snake is a property and real estate manager.
I'm proud to live here. I'm proud to say I'm a member of this community.
But she didn't always feel that way. Not when she moved here in 1964, when the few businesses were owned by non-natives, when many houses didn't have indoor plumbing, when alcoholism was rampant, people passed out all along the streets.
It was really bad, you know. And I remember crying and not wanting to live here.
But now, helping paint the Winnebagos a brighter economic picture, Sarah's tears of pain are tears of pride.
When I'm putting those keys in their hand, I swear I always shed a tear because it's a dream that I had for myself that never happened. You know, so now I can make that possible for somebody.
And those we talked with say not all the problems are gone, but now instead of asking, can we do something, they're asking, what more can we do? And they're happy to be asking that question.